survival, just so just from here, you're doing whatever, and you're going over and you're here. And in that, they're resisting quite strongly. They seem to know what they're doing. So if they get their elbow down, you've still got to pull it back here. And you want to use your legs. So even just going like this and squeezing your legs together and pushing them in and pushing them away is better. I see a lot of people, they try and do this sort of stuff, which means it's loose as hell here, liable to get injured if he comes through. So using this lever here of hand through to your knee and pushing that up here and taking this way, their arm is a lot weaker here. The more it comes down into the middle, the stronger they are. So one is, sit your body up this angle, straighten that leg so the head points that way. Does that all help you? Bring your knees up together and lock them in and squeeze them, that will help. Then feet this high here, because this one's called rock the baby, like a cradle rock, here. The second one is just, if they start to pull in towards you and it's too loose, and they start to turn towards you, he starts to get his elbow in, what you've got to do is you've got to go back with two hands and pull on the elbow and pull it up so that they don't take out your groin. And then bring it back to your chest, because you need the surface area of their arm on your chest. If you get the back of their arm here on your gut and you pull it in tight to your gut and then you squeeze your knees, then lock it tight around the shoulders. Squeeze so tight they can hardly cut the blood off in their arm. And then from here, he grabs his hands together still. He's got a lot of pressure there. Then you need to be, see, he's caught me on the forearm. I need to be elbow to elbow. So I've got to push it this way and bring it up, feet high to keep it up and weaker. And with this one, it's simply, if you just pull on this side and lock it over, and that comes apart. So this one, if he's got the hands together here, this one's a push one. Yeah, that's a push one. And this one here, I don't know, we'll go in between. I just pressure this one. Yeah, just pressure it like that. A lot of them can be pressured if you've got it. It squeezed really tight here. And you squeeze your legs in, lock it tight, and toes it in. Usually they'll let go. Armlock, basically. So you're getting me however where you want to. Yep. So this one here is just under and hold it there. Look towards them. Come around here with the video probably. But look towards them. Grab their jacket, pull it in and smile at them. Here. And we're gonna stack them. One more time. He's got me with it. Keep the arm in as tight as you can. I like that thing here and there. And then you've got to put your hand under the knee and slip it to here and then hold that for a second while you bridge up with your neck and you turn towards him then. And this hand goes from here, it's going to grab their collar and pull it in. Yeah. So grab it here if you can. Up higher is probably easier. And then you're gonna rock your body towards them and come around the side. And then you've got to basically from here, you elbow them. Right. If it's held here, if you make your arm circular, instead of he wants it pointed, they want it pointed here. They want the point. All of a sudden you relax here, but you've got to go through quickly to withdraw it. So you kind of, it was here, and then you're making a wheel of it. And you're shifting the edge of the circle. That's another one. Okay, it's hard if you pull it in for them to extend it out. So it's still possible, but it's hard. And what happens is usually to get out of it, you go from here, you pull them over this way, and then you put the leg behind here and then pull it in to get out of it. But it's still, I like to feed the inside of my armpit, or I like to grab here and then lock it in. And for him, if he wants to bend my wrist, well,
Yeah, see, he can just bend it like that. This way, put your hand here and then just move your body forward to get that.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then I'll let go. So he hides it from the referee. He moves it forward until it puts the wrist lock on and then flicks it up and goes back through the a slight wrist lock if he moves it. Yeah. And so to defend against this, you've got to keep your arm straight. So when he tries to bend wrist, you keep it dead straight. Don't let your wrist bend it at all. And so for this, you've got to kind of be fixated on keeping the center line, the knuckle center line. And when you hold, and just don't let him bend your wrist. Okay? So my defense again is just here, hold, pull in tight here. And then I'll do a backward roll, I'll come out here, and I'll do a backward roll, and I'll elbow in the guts, and I'll try and